good afternoon. I'd like to talk to you a little bit this afternoon about Catholic evangelization. We hear a lot about evangelization today in the church, missionary discipleship. And yet it's a very scary word for a lot of people because Catholics often associate evangelization with Protestant evangelism. And evangelism is the process where many Pentecostals and evangelicals will meet someone and feel that it's necessary for them to introduce the person to Jesus. Often you'll hear an evangelical or a Pentecostal ask you, are you saved? Or is Jesus your personal Savior? Now this sometimes puts, people on their guard and they kind of, it's almost impolite to be able to do that. And we Catholics shy away from that. But Catholics are not necessarily called to evangelism. It's evangelization, and that's different. Evangelization is a process where we are converted to be missionary disciples, joining in the way of Jesus, following his way of life. Now, this isn't anything new, but most of us who are older Catholics grew up believing that the mission of the church was all about the salvation of souls. Well, in a way it is, but Jesus effected the salvation of souls by his death and resurrection. The mission of the church is to evangelize, to proclaim the kingdom of God. And in order to do that, we're supposed to somehow or other, in our own witnessing and in our own daily lives, attract people to our way of life in following Jesus. Now, unfortunately, this doesn't seem to be working today. The number of people in our churches keeps dropping, and especially among the younger demographics, teenagers, young adults, children, you just don't see a lot of them in church. Churches today are mostly full of middle-aged people and older people. And why is that? And I think one of the reasons is that we haven't done a good job of planting the seeds of religious imagination in our children. Now, evangelization really isn't anything new in the Catholic Church. Back in the 1970s, Pope Paul VI put out a landmark document called Evangelii Nuntiandi, in which he basically laid out that the mission of the church is to evangelize. And in fact, this isn't something that he came up with. Every baptized Christian, whether you're Catholic or another Christian denomination, is called to be a missionary disciple. And we can look at our own rite of baptism, and it's laid out right there. And most of us who are older probably have learned that baptism is about getting rid of original sin. Well, that's true. But there are other aspects, and they're laid out right in the rite of baptism, which point to the other reasons we get baptized. So, sure, there's the pouring of the water on the child's head, the coming into the dying and rising of Christ, and the removal of original sin. But there is a second element right after the child is baptized, where he is anointed, or she is anointed. And she's anointed with the chrism of salvation, the holy chrism. And then the priest or deacon says, so that you may remain a member of Christ as priest, prophet, and king. And that means that you're anointed to participate in Jesus' mission and his ministry as a priest, prophet, and king. Now we do that in many, many ways, and following that anointing comes the clothing with a white garment. And the priest says, this is a sign of your Christian dignity with your family and friends to help you by word and example. Now this is the witnessing that we talk about. To witness well. guarantee you, by the time that child is 5 or 6 years old, they will come to realize baptism is a big deal. Baptism is a big deal. And to connect the dot, that came home to me because I remember I was talking to a priest once, and we were talking about what is the most important sacrament you can get. And then, you know, I went down the list, and he said, no, you know, that's not it. Communion's not it. Confirmation's not it. Marriage isn't it. Holy Word. It's the most important one is baptism. Because without it, we can't get any of the others. So baptism initiates us into this ministry of Jesus, into being disciples. It is the most important sacrament that we get. Now, I mentioned that we are candle people, and kids love candles. So I want to give you a couple of other suggestions that might help you inspire a child's religious imagination. And let's go through some seasons that are coming up here in the church in the next couple of months. We've got, you know, Advent coming up. Well, as I said, kids love candles. How about the Advent wreath? Now, we do have the Advent wreath here in church, but what if you had one of those Advent wreaths at home, and everybody at dinner, for each of the weeks, you follow the ritual and light the candle? Now, little kids love it. I'm telling you, they love it. And if you do that, and you do the prayer, it makes an impression. It fires a child's religious imagination. Now, some other suggestions that come along as we get into Christmas. Again, we're candle people, and we all have Christmas trees. But what about the nativity scene? How about this year, instead of putting out on the lawn a bunch of reindeer and
Thank you, Deacon Paul. And next week, Mr. Troy Lawson, our music director, is actually going to be presenting a talk similarly on evangelization, but on Friday, not Thursday. So that's October 16th at 4 p.m. We hope you tune in then. Have a wonderful weekend.